Hi folks, this is David Kwan here, and I'm doing this outside for like the first time in a long time ever. The last time I did something like this outside was, you know, years ago when I walked from my apartment in Brooklyn to the Bronx. So I did the whole adventure kind of thing there, and I filmed while I was walking. But this time I'm sitting down. I'm on campus. This is the Washington Square Park, and that's the Bulbs Library right there. I come here quite often because, you know, I'm a graduate student at NYU. But, yeah, I'm also ridiculously, oddly self-conscious right now. I feel really awkward being here talking to my iPhone in the middle of everyone walking around being New Yorkers, you know. I don't know. It just feels really weird. I can't promise you if I'll do this more often from now on, but I just thought, hey, I'm out here, why not? Just figured to just vlog myself. And today, you know, I want to talk about yesterday, actually. So I actually feel bad that I should have talked about this much sooner. Maybe if I had a bigger following, I would have done much more of this, because it's, you know, it's yesterday was the midterm elections, and I did vote. So that's that. First time I ever voted in my life, because, well, I recently became a U.S. citizen just this year. So I wasn't able to vote until this year. So I did register, and I did vote. Voting itself was actually a lot. I'm in New York City, I'm in Brooklyn, so maybe it's the experience here. It was really convenient, really easy. The place that was open to me was like a big daycare center, but it was open from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m., so those are really convenient. If I had a 9-to-5 job, or if I had my internship on that day, which I actually do, but because it was election day, my internship was like, don't come to internship today, which was nice. But yeah, if I had a 9-to-5 job, like, I could make it there, because it closes at 9 p.m. So I actually did go at 7 p.m. after I did my laundry. So it was good. Like, I just meet with the certain tables at my district. They asked me for my address, so I gave them my address, and then they gave me this big old binder with the paper inside. On that paper is the ballot. And although I regret, you know, I feel really bad that, you know, they asked me for my ID and I didn't fight it. So I feel like I should have, because, you know, ID is not something that should be required to vote after you register to vote. You know, I'm already registered in there. But the person who asked me for the ID also, like, mentioned, like, this is weird, I don't know what to do. You were the first person that we had, you're the only person that we had that, you know, it says on this paper, needs ID. It didn't say photo ID, so I don't think a photo ID is required, but just an ID. I think this is the case just because I'm a recently U.S. citizen. But, you know, I have lots of IDs and photo IDs, so that's not a problem for me. But I do know that requiring voter ID to vote disenfranchises lots of people, particularly, you know, people of color and women who get married and things like that. So I feel kind of bad that I didn't, like, be like, no, well, I'm not going to show you my ID, but I didn't fight it. I was just like, okay, here's my driver's license, take a look at it, and then they're like, okay. So I got to vote. Voting was really easy, just the process-wise. The whole actual voting thing, like, was kind of, I had to do my homework the prior day, but the homework was hard, you know, figuring out who will be on the ballot, what kind of people are they, those people who are on the ballot, and what will be on the ballot, you know, what am I actually voting for? Figuring that out, like, that was homework for me, you know, and so I did that the day before the election, so on Monday, and I feel like it should be easier for citizens. There should be an easier way for citizens to become more aware, more informed about what they're voting for. You know, I think every incumbent should have, like, a blog, and every person in office should have their own blog or should have their website to explain, you know, what they're about and what their has been. There's also a cool website that has all the voting records and voting experiences of candidates, but half of the pages that I looked at didn't really work properly, so there's that, and it was really hard to get, like, detailed information about it. Some of the bills that were kind of on, or amendments that were on for vote in my election, they had three bills. A lot of it seemed really, there's a redistricting bill, which is really, like, weirdly worded. You know, they're going to sign up a commission every 10 years to redistrict the voting zones. That's really complicated. But, and then there's another one about electronic bills. So if the bills get made, then if I voted yes, then it would allow for Congress or lawmakers to be electronically emailed the bills and certain kind of regulations around that. There was that bill. And the third one was the sale of state bonds to fund schools' technology and internet capacity and things like that. So those are the three bills that were, like, on the ballot to vote for in my district, I suppose. That I voted for. But yeah, I do feel, you know, that at least it should be more aware, and there should be more effort, you know, by everyone involved in the political process to get the vote out, to get more awareness out there. Midterm elections are, unfortunately, you know, there's not a lot of energy surrounding them, and there's typically a low turnout, but it's a very important election because it really determines the local politicians. And it's really the local politicians who makes a lot of the laws, a lot of the changes, a lot more than what, you know, Congress or the nationals or legislatures can do, especially in a period of gridlock like it was the past 2 years. Now, because Republicans took over the House and the Senate, there's probably not going to be as much gridlock, and that's great for, I guess, Republicans, and not so great for people who are not... for Republicans. But yeah, that's been my voting experience. It's been really interesting. It's a lot more convenient than I thought it would be, the voting process itself. And I just feel it's really weird to be kind of in a country where, you know, we pride ourselves in being a democracy, but a lot of us don't practice or exercise the right to actually vote and go to elections. So that's my thoughts. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.